Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be going over how to turn your 3D models into IKEA-esque like diagrams. In a previous video, we showed how to model this shelf based on some IKEA drawings, but we're sort of going to do a little bit of the reverse of that. We're going to turn this into an IKEA style diagram. Now, if I go to this IKEA style diagram, you can see just the line quality is subtly different than what SketchUp produces. So we're going to start off from SketchUp and do some changes. Let me just dock my tray over here, turn off shadows, and then go to styles. And if you just really quickly want to do this, you just want to make sure that you have go to edit your current style, and then you want to go to the face settings and choose display in hidden line only. Now my edges aren't very crisp here, but what you can see when we zoom in a little bit is that everything has a similar line weight. So if you go to the edges here, if we turn off the edges or mess around with some of these settings, the profiles is really the key here in getting a more IKEA-esque diagram. So if we take that to the nth degree, you can see that actually a lot of these shapes look like they are exactly what is happening in SketchUp. So there is like this outline here, there's a dark line here, and then the underside line here is picked up. So if we go to the IKEA, you can see this outline, and then there's an edge here, an edge on the bottom, not the top. So it has the same sort of quality, but the thing you need to be careful of is just obviously you don't want to go too thick. And what is actually happening here is that some of these lines aren't working. So because you can't really like tell SketchUp what to pick and what not to pick, what I like to do is just turn this off. We're just going to take these edges, we're going to export this as a 2D graphic, and then we are going to export it as an EPS file. Call this, let's say, shelf. So we'll call this shelf. And then we're going to be using Illustrator for this, but anything that can open any sort of vector file is what you want to use. So we're going to be using Illustrator just because I have it. And then we are going to open shelf EPS. So we're going to open that. So what happens when you save an EPS file is that it has the line work. So we are going to, let's see, when I select this. So this is a little too small. So we're just going to scale it up. What you don't want to happen is that all your lines essentially blend together. Like what was happening there, or that you can only go like so small. So you want to scale it up so that you can start to actually mess with the line weight. So we're going to come to here, and then I am going to ungroup so that we can select our lines, release compound path. So now we have our lines here. Now I know that the outside here, we just want to kind of break all these things up so that we can select single lines. So we have these guys. So I'm just selecting, holding shift to select all these lines. You can also drag. And we're just gonna bump these up, let's say one. It looks pretty good. Just wanna come in. One. Just make sure you're selecting all your lines. One. One. Now this goes all the way across. So we have a clipping masks we need to get rid of here. Release the compound path. I'm not a pro at using Illustrator, so there may be I've had a lot of experience with other software like Photoshop, but not so much with Illustrator, so there may be faster ways to do this. And if you know of any, please share them in the comments below. It would be awesome to get some input. So let's just reference this again. So we have the underside edge and then basically the outline, and then these outer shapes are also outlined. Just being very diligent with how you do it. And I'm just gonna go through and we will do this quickly. We'll just do one shape and then I will speed this up so you guys can see. You guys don't have to sit here through the whole thing as I do this, but you still get the effect of me doing everything. And this guy looks a little thick because of it's just there's two lines there that are right next to each other. So after we finish this shape, then we will speed this video up and you can see the final product. So there we go. Hopefully this video helped. If it did, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers. Just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.